Welcome. Don't be a stranger. Welcome. Don't be a stranger.
What do you got for me? Come again.
Was only ravel ore.
Aw, boo! I was hoping it'd be diamonds or something. But thanks for showing me anyway. Most people would have just told me not to bother them. Chester was always real nice to me, too. I'd always be up in his business, and he never once scolded me for it. He'd always play with me and Elena, and he even took us on walks outside the town sometimes. And he taught me how to fish, too. You'd think it'd be boring, but it's not. It's actually real fun. He's not here anymore, though. He went someplace far away. Sometimes, I feel like he's never gonna come back.
Thank you. Chester. Adol. I'm sorry. I've just got a lot on my mind. My brother gave me this pendant. He left it here in a letter for me, on the day he vanished. I guess it makes me feel closer to him when I wear it. But in reality, he was closer than I ever realized all this time. I'm so sorry, Adol. So many horrible rumors have been going around about my brother. And then, to hear the man who raised me confirm them all? I just want to know what's happening and why. He must have a reason, right? Maybe I'm being selfish. I should just be grateful he's alive. In a way, it's like a weight I've been carrying for the last 6 months has been lifted from me. I may not know what's going through his mind just yet, but I do know that if I could talk to him, just talk to him, then things might go back to normal. Don't worry about me. I'll be okay. But thank you for your concern, Adol. I really do appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. This has become quite serious indeed. Why would Father Pierre go to such a place?
Please forgive me. I should have tried harder to stop him.
My, my. Such blazing red hair. You must be Adol. I've heard murmurings about you amongst the townsfolk. My name is Nicholas. I am head of the Felghana diocese. I was also the town's priest until 3 years ago. Now I serve at the castle, while Father Pierre enlightens the town. I still drop by from time to time, though. Old habits do die hard, as they say. I fear, however, that my visit today may be a bit less transient than usual on account of Father Pierre's absence. Are you familiar with the Ilburn's ruins to the northeast of here? They are the remnants of a temple used by practitioners of a pagan religion from a long-lost era. It would seem that Father Pierre has taken it upon himself to visit that temple for purposes unknown.
It's unsafe in every regard. There's a dormant volcano behind it which has recently become active anew. And popular rumor suggests the place is infested with monsters of all shapes and sizes.
All the more reason for concern. One cannot help but fear the worst. Adol Christin. They say you're the one who rescued Mayor Edgar from the quarry. Is this true? Given your considerable skill, might I humbly request you undertake another such mission to find Father Pierre? Such selfless courage. On behalf of the church, you have my deepest gratitude. I believe you will be needing this. The Ilburn's ruins are just off the road, to the northeast of here. This key opens the access gate. Please, do whatever you can to ensure the safety of Father Pierre. May God be with you. Fight well, adventurer.
Thank you. Thank you. What are you doing here?
I could just as easily ask you that same question, Father Pierre. This is not a fit place for the likes of you. If you value your life, I suggest you leave at once.
Chester, you should at least let Elena know what you're doing, and that you're okay. She's been worried sick. She's never stopped looking for you. After all this time, not once has she lost hope.
That's no concern of yours, Father. Keep sticking your nose where it doesn't belong, and it's liable to get cut off.
Well, well.
Seems these ruins have a little rat problem.
Adol?
I warned you not to get involved. But since you seem incapable of following orders, you leave me little choice.
En garde! Here we go! Ta-da! Take that! Gotcha! Here we go! Not... Take that! Gotcha! Here we go! Here we go!
I underestimated you. So, you're not all talk. You actually have some skill. Which means I needn't go easy on you.
Stop this, both of you!
I'd advise you to stand aside, holy man. Let's see what you're made of.
Men, seize them!
Well, if it isn't Lord Maguire. May I ask what brings you to such a place, my lord?
What brings me? Why, I merely thought I might come to worship at the seat of my future home. And what should I find when I get here but my top knight dealing with intruders? So, tell me, who are these people?
The clergyman is Redmont's head priest. And the swordsman with the red hair is the latest adventurer to cross these lands.
Ah, an adventurer, you say? Hmm, a meddlesome priest is bad enough, but an adventurer? Simply won't do at all. I imagine he hopes to get his hands on my statues. No matter. We will dispose of him here.
If that is your will, my lord. I know of a place nearby that is most suitable for meeting out a man's final judgment. I believe you'll find it quite to your liking.
Will I now? Very well then, take me there at once.
As you wish.
A precipice high above the lava pits. Wait. This should make quick work of him. All right, do it!
If you'd simply minded your own business as I ordered, this wouldn't be necessary. But now, your fate is sealed.
Could you? God will never forgive this sinful behavior.
You certainly do like to prattle on, Father. Take him to the dungeon. Chester, you're doing well. I leave the rest in your capable hands.
You honor me, my lord. I shall find the statue here without fail.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, you've come. It would seem you've acquired two of the powers of generals. I cannot simply allow this to pass uncontested. The blazing jaws of hell itself shall consume you.
That was faster than I'd anticipated. I had every confidence you'd make it back alive. And with the statue, no less. I must admit, I'm impressed. Now, hand them over, both of them. Don't play dumb with me either. I know you're the one who defeated that creature in the quarry.
Chester, don't!
Elena? Dogi? You shouldn't be here. Why have you come?
Sister Nell told us that Adol had come here to look for Father Pierre. Dogi had just returned and was going to follow him, so I came too.
No end of trouble, I swear. Freezing my ass off climbing the Elder Mountains with monsters all around me and no equipment worth a damn. So I go back to town to regroup and try again. And what do I hear? The mayor's been hurt and Adol's off the ruins. And Chester, you've been missing for 6 months? What the hell, man?
Chester. I don't mind that you've become one of Count McGuire's knights. No matter what people say you've done, you're still my brother. If you're truly following your heart, I would never stand in your way. But why? Why are you doing this? Why would you kidnap a priest or try to hurt Adol? And how come you never contacted me, even just to let me know you were still alive?
Are you done? I left town because I found the menial existence offered me there to be utterly repugnant. I wasn't thrilled at the prospect of babysitting you for the rest of my life, either, Elena.
What?
I thought that if I became one of McGuire's knights, I could move up in the world and make something of myself. As opposed to living a peasant's existence in some backwater town, biding my time until I die of boredom. It was all dragging me down, Elena. Living life in a place where nothing matters is the height of tedium. Not just one element of it either, but every part of every day. You. The town, my past, everything, all meaningless.
What are you saying?
Chester, you son of a bitch! What the hell is wrong with you?
I could ask the same thing. You have no right to feel indignant, Dogi. I simply chose the same path in life as you. Or have you conveniently forgotten that you abandoned Redmont on a whim 8 years ago? None of us are children anymore. Keep your statues for now. I'm sure they'll be safest in your care. As I said, I became one of Count McGuire's knights to rid myself of my past. That includes you, Dogi. You are no longer a part of my life. I suggest you forget about me and move along. Get in my way and you'll be very, very sorry.
I still can't believe what happened at the ruins. What can Chester possibly be thinking?
Mayor, I hate to say this, but we have larger concerns at the moment. The closure of the quarry is bad enough, but to threaten a priest on top of it all. Chester's a factor, yes, but I think our first priority should be Maguire. He is indisputably the root of our problems.
Yes, you're right, of course. Bishop Nicholas, do you have any inkling as to what Count Maguire may be after?
I'm afraid not. But then, he's never been one to talk openly about his affairs. His wife and their two children attend morning mass without him, always. I do find it hard to believe, though, that he'd try and claim authority beyond that of the church.
What would you suggest we do about Father Pierre, then?
As head of the Felghana Diocese, it is my duty to oversee the well-being of all members of the clergy. When I return to the castle, I intend to have a talk with the Count. Fear not. I should be able to secure Father Pierre's release.
Much obliged on that.
I'll leave Father Pierre to you, then. Thank you.
I must say, though, I am a bit concerned about these statues Count Maguire has Chester searching for. May we see the two you've found thus far, Adol?
Adol produced the statues from his pack. Interesting. And very unique.
So, the big critters regarding these?
I sense an unusual power from within them. It's possible there may be a link between these statues and the recent monster appearances.
What?
How do you figure?
Well, this is pure conjecture on my part. But these two come from the quarry and the ruins, both of which seem to be hotbeds for monster activity as of late. And each was guarded by a large creature of unusual strength. Does that not strike you as more than mere coincidence?
You may be right. And if that's the case, we'd be especially foolish to let the Count get his hands on them. I think we should safeguard them until we know exactly what's happening. What's wrong, Dewey?
Oh, nothing. I just get the feeling I've seen these statues somewhere before.
What?
Come on, out with it, Dewey!
I'm thinking. It's not like this was just yesterday. It was down inside the old abandoned mine, if I recall correctly. There was a mural painted on the wall.
Abandoned mine?
It's an old deep section of the Tigray quarry that we exhausted long ago. Been closed off ever since. We found a really ornate mural painted on one of the walls there. Can't even imagine how old it was. But if memory serves, it depicted four statues that looked an awful lot like the ones we've got here.
Could there really be a connection?
Well, it certainly warrants an investigation.
All right! Hey, Adol, what say we split our efforts? I think I have an idea. I'll get my stuff together and return to the Elder Mountains while you head to the abandoned mine.
Ah, you intend to see Bearheart?
Yeah, the old master. He knows more about Felghana's legends and folklore than anyone else, so he can probably fill in some of the blanks. Plus, you might know something about Chester's situation. He was Chester's master too, after all. You might have some idea why that idiot's been acting like such a jackass.
I'll speak with Chester directly at the castle. He may be more likely to grant Father Pierre's release than Maguire. I'll also see if I can learn anything pertinent about the statues while I'm there.
Sounds like a plan. Hope you can talk your way through that thick skull of his. Adol, I'll catch you later. Good luck in the abandoned mine. Don't get yourself killed without me, you got it? If you have a chance, too, be sure to check in on Elena. I feel so bad for her. Poor kid. Let's make sure we get this all sorted out, for her sake.
All right, Adol. The entrance to the abandoned mine is next to the quarry storehouse, at the bottom of that first vertical shaft. I'll go on ahead and get the door open, since the lock's kind of tricky. Get your stuff together and meet me there, okay?
Are you sure that's wise, Dewey? Monsters aside, remember the quarry's off-limits right now. If McGuire's men catch you there...
It won't be a problem. I'll bring Paul and Ricardo for manpower, and we'll be in and out before anyone's the wiser. Got it, Adol? Don't keep us waiting. You know where we'll be, so hurry up.
Almighty God, please deliver me from temptation, guide my path straight and true, and grant mercy upon the innocent. Lord, I... Adol? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you come in. I was in the middle of my prayers. If you're here to keep me apprised of things, I'm afraid you're too late. Bishop Nicholas has already filled me in. The situation certainly has gotten quite out of hand. I simply don't understand why the Count would take Father Pierre prisoner. I hope no harm comes to him. And Chester, how could he commit such vile acts? I'm sorry, please excuse me. I lost my composure for a moment. You need to be very careful out there, Adol. Something is happening to Felghana. Something most unholy. I can feel it.
Welcome. Don't be a stranger. Welcome. Don't be a stranger.
What do you got for me? This the one? Good to go. This the good to go. This good to go. This look good to go. Come again.
Fine mess we've got here in Felghana, no? Chester's the big shocker for me. He's had a dignified air about him ever since he was a child. We always suspected that he might be the son of a nobleman or some such thing, but there's nothing noble about Maguire. Dogi, on the other hand, was a total mess as a child, and look at him now! Though I suppose I can't really compare, since I know nothing at all about Chester's life before Redmond. The events of his distant past could hold the missing puzzle piece that gives valid context to all his actions. But then, what do I know? The more I think about it, the more I realize just how pointless it is to think about it.
Wait! The
Thank goodness I caught you. I wanted to apologize. For what Chester did, I mean. I know it's little comfort, but he's my brother, and I felt I should give you something as an apology on his behalf. It's a family heirloom of sorts. Adoptive family heirloom, anyway. Full of spiritual energy. Supposedly, if you envision one of the old travel monuments while stroking its feathers, you'll be sent right there. Think of it as a very useful good luck charm. As for me, I'll be all right. I've been contemplating all the horrible things my brother's been doing. And I know I should be angry with them, and I am, don't get me wrong. But no matter what, he's still my brother. I'll always love him just the same. He's the only true family I have. So, like I said, I'll be all right. I don't know if I got through to him or not. I just know that I want all this to stop. He's putting himself and everyone else in such danger. Oh, Adol. If you see my brother again on your travels, would you please tell him something for me? Don't go out of your way to find him, of course. I just mean, if you cross paths again, tell him I said thank you for the pendant.
Adol silently nodded his consent.
I appreciate it, Adol. I'm such a mess. Rhyme doesn't help anything. You're headed to the abandoned mine, right? Please, be extra careful. For me, okay?